primary school 的线 ，it is a primary street from Irving Primary School. For this lesson, it will still be calculus, chapter 7, double and triple integral. For this lesson, we won't just use double integral, but we have a little bit of revision of single integral like last lesson. So first, of course, you need to draw the graph. So let's see what's this question, okay? So this question, which says that evaluate the area bounded by the parabola y equals to x squared over 2x, straight lines x equals 1, x equals 3, and y equals 0. Okay? So here, what I mean by parabola? It means by quadratic curve. Okay? So, of course, first draw the graph. So here, something like this, then now let's draw the curves or the straight lines. So the curve, which is the x squared over 2, so something like this. Now for the straight line, first x equals to 1, so now it will be something like this. Then now for this part with x equals to 3, we need to reach till the top. So now which part we are finding? Well, but is it totally correct? Still got y equals 0. Because that if we don't have y equals 0, below here also get. Okay? So, here y equals 0. Like this. So we're finding this whole thing. We'll have four methods like last time, and then after the four methods, so how last lesson, the four methods, which two of them are double and two of them are single, and those two, the twos are actually either y first or either x first. It will be the same method for this time, except for, of course, the solving method. Even though it's the same method, but how to solve is a bit different, okay? So here, let's first use way 1. Use no way. So way 1, could we have y first? You know why? So here, y first, it will be something like Something like this. Okay. We're finding for this part, okay? This. Something like this, okay? Now, how let's go on with the method. Method one. Verticals, yes, and then first we'll also have the single integral, only one, okay. Because for the other one, we could assume it's zero and already put it in the integral, okay. So here, let's see, first dx or first, I mean, is it dx or is it dy? It's dx because that even though the vertical means that it's one row by one row like this, which means following the x axis. Well, it's increasing by the x squared over 2. Okay? The height is increasing. That's what I mean. So here, the area, best to write this if not are you finding the whatever, whatever, okay? So here, and this, and you are very sure that definitely it's the area. So here, area, which equals to integral. Let's see from where to where. The line starts from this part, 1 till 3. Let me tell you, lines, how much lines? They're infinity lines. Because even you may thought that it's just line, we could just cut it like that, but actually inside this line, there are even more thinner and thinner lines. Okay? So inside a line, there's infinity lines. So inside this whole thing, there's already infinity lines. Okay? And plus, let me tell you that infinity is never a number, so don't say that the infinity is a number. Infinity is a number, but this number keep on increasing. So now, let's go on. So here, where to where? As I just now say, 1 till 3. And of course, this integral which is over here, it's over there because that. If you did notice, it's keep increasing. Actually, only this part stays the same. The rest are all increased. Okay? So here, let's have x squared over 2 dx. Okay? So like this. Now, of course, integrate. It's quite simple. Though, so let's sub it in. Sub it in. Should we simplify the 3? Nope. 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 Do you know why? Because that. If you simplify the 3, it will be dumb to do that. Because that at last we still need to combine them together, which is common denominator, and they cancel. But if you Well, simplify the 3, the numerator and denominator, and I still need to times that 3. It will be no good. Okay? So here. Three to the power of 3, 27. So 27 over 6. What is it? So 27 over 6, we don't simplify yet. Still need to minus 1 cube, still 1, so 1 over 6. Let's common denominator and minus it. So it becomes 26 over 6. But more like it, right? You know why? Because then you could simplify now. 13 over 6. Just kidding. 13 over 3. Okay? So here. Let's change it to mixed number. Your answer could be improper. Your answer also can mix. So here. Let me just write it improper if you want. So here, 1 over 3. 4 and 1 over 3. That's the answer. Yay. So here. Now we have done the for the first method. Let me just tell you something like this. Something like this, okay? Now, for the next method. So for the first method, it's already quite simple. But when still not sure, is it the simplest? Do you know why? Because there's 3 more methods. As I said, there's 4 methods. And 4 methods, we'll see which one is the most complicated and which one is the most easiest. Do you know why? Because if you know it, you're doing a competition, for example. If got this kind of question, you know which one is the easiest method. But you must know all the methods in case there's another type of question with the other method is the best. Okay? So now, for way 2. So for way 2, area. So let's see. Wait a second. So now, let's see for here. Okay, here we go. For this part, let's first calculate the rectangle part. So since it's a rectangle, so this is times y the base, y the height. So the height, like the left sub 1 is 1, 1 sub in, 1 squared still 1, 1 over 2. So here becomes half times, let's see, oh, half times. Let's just use half to time. Now what about this part? From 1 to 3, so minus become difference 2. So simplify, simplify 1. Okay? So now, here, let's have first, we already calculate this out for the rectangle part. So 1, after that, still need to plus, which is this part. So we'll need to use the integral. So where should we start from? Let's see, here we end from half, because we sub it in, and plus here, and now at this power is for the top, so 3 sub it in, 3 square 9, 9, then over 2, so 9 over 2. Okay? It's first y or first, I mean it's a y with respect to y or with respect to x, it's with respect to y. Since just now we've done with respect to x. Okay? So now, here. Let's see. Something like this, which now will separate and take out the coefficient that we can take out. So here 1 plus 3 integral from half to 9 over 2 dy. Then now for this part, we have a negative, so negative positive still a negative. Then here, we could take out the square root 2, then integral from half to 9 over 2. Here, dy still, and in front of the dy, it will become the square root y, okay? So now we could integrate, except for here, because here no need. So 1 plus 3y sub from half till 9 over 2. Then now for this part, minus, and then so minus square root 2, so here integrate become 2 over 3, then square root, let's see, so y cube sub from half to 9 over 2, like this. So now, here 1 plus, so let's sub it in, so 27 over 2 minus 3 over 2, so something like this. Now my, wait, it is a minus, then here 9 over 2. So for square root 2. So after that, it becomes 2 square root 2 over 3. And now 9 for the 9 cube. 9 over 2 bracket cube. Become 9 over 2 came out. Then inside the square root there's another 9 over 2 which we put. Also make it came out which becomes 3 over square root 2. So here we got 75. And now for the next step, for the half. So half square root 2, 2 over 3. Here we have the 1 over 2 and the 1 over square root 2. So here actually these will simplify, this and this, this will simplify. So of course that's just common denominator, these two, and can sort out some parts. So it will become 1 plus 12. Then after that, minus 9 plus, let's simplify, then 1 over 3. Now for this part, we could, so here, then just 4 and 1 over 3. Okay, so you can, just now I go like this because that had, in this case, it will become something like this, okay? So that's why. But you also can change this to the other one if you want. So now these are the first two methods. Get a quick look, okay. Okay, so now way 3 is still vertical, except for it's gonna be double integral. So let's just take one of the small one because that had we took it. Let me just enlarge the small part because later on they tell you. Here would be its dy and here is its dx. And for this part, instead of like this vertical, we put it like this small box by small box like this. Except for it's just going to be y first, okay? So, x starting from where and where? Okay, so starting from 1 because here, then end at 3, You got this. So now the other integral is for dy. So which to with where? So let's see. Starting from 0 till x squared over 2, because that is over here. Okay? So now we could try to integrate, because that over here, in front stays the same, behind already can integrate since it just having no coefficients. What I mean in variables. Okay? So here, y sub from 0 to x squared over 2, and then here dx. So 1 over 3 x squared over 2 dx. Just now we calculated already, which is the first way, and left for this case. What we get is a 4 and 1 over 3, okay? So something like this, the answer is still the same. Because we could take the first and second method to help with the third and fourth method, okay? So actually some method may be the longest, but because that you borrow other answers, so it become shorter. So now for way 4. Now for this part, but even so in this part, the only thing that changed is just its first x now, and nothing else changed. This is still the same picture, okay? So now, the area. Let's see what will it equals to. So double integral. The only difference is just that it's dx first, then dy. Okay? Like this. And then in front still need a 1 plus, because that over here we calculated it. So like just so 1 plus here, because that still has this rectangle. So that's why this, if we use horizontal, it's not so good. We still need to calculate it out, okay? So here, now starting from where? Half, as just now, which we sub in by this till 9 over 2, and this part which is starting from square root 2 y till 3. Okay? So equals to 1 plus, still the same. We can integrate it already. So 9 over 2 x sub in from square root 2 y till 3 dy. So here 1 plus integral half till 9 over 2, here 3 minus square root 2 y bracket dy. Just now we also done like this, so we could use that answer to replace with this, okay? So it will be 4 and 1 over 3. Wait a second, then just type, if you say out all the steps again, actually this stronger because you still got the spot. Okay? So now we'll end here. Next time we'll continue. Hope you understand and see you for next time. If you like our videos, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you for your watching.